Now, the next category of the aerial stem possible is the weak stems, which are upright, but they are not strong enough to be upright. So they need some support. That means they need some external support. Then only they are able to stand straight. So the types are twiners and climbers. Now, what are twiners? You must have seen there are plants which will twine around a structure. So they will coil around a structure, maybe in the clockwise manner or in the anti-clockwise manner. So they don't develop any special structure, they only coil around. So because they are coiling around a structure, they are called as twiners. So twiners, they have long, flexible, sensitive stem. Remember, they perform thigmotropism. They are able to touch and feel where is the support, and they will start moving around the support. So they coil around a support. Example, there are many plants. For example, Ipomea palmata, which is also called as railway creeper. There are other plants like, for example, Clitoria is there, which is blue color butterfly pea type of plants. Flowers are there. So there are many plants in which you will find coiling of the stem or the weak stems, green stems, around a external support takes place. Such plants are twiner. Now, apart from twiner, the second category possible is climbers. Now, what are climbers? Climbers have weak stem, their flexible stems are there, and they climb up a support with the help of different structures. So they may have different structures to climb up. For example, they may develop roots. If they develop roots to climb, then they are called as root climbers. And root climbers, example is Scindaspus. You gave the scientific names in the last class. Some student called it as Epipremnum. It's correct. There are synonyms also of scientific names. Or Pothos, in general knowledge, it is called, general English, it is called as Pothos also, money plant also. In the same manner, I talked about tendril few minutes back. Or you, if you talk about pea plant, pea also develops tendril. Now, tendrils also help the plant to climb up. So, tendril climbers, for example, pea. Then there are plants which are called as scramblers or ramblers. Now, scramblers and ramblers are those which develop thorns. In few minutes back in the class, we learned about thorns are modification of buds in bougainvillea. So, bougainvillea climbs up a tree or climbs up any other plant because it will produce thorns, and those thorns will fix here and there in the branches of the other plant, and this is how bougainvillea try to climb up. So such plants are called as scramblers or ramblers. And if there is a woody climber, like for example, you all know about gloe, which is a medicinal plant, scientific name Tinospora cordifolia. So in this plant, these plants are called as lianas. So lianas are woody type of climber which are able to climb up because they develop woody structure and they twine around. So remember, they are twiners also, but remember, twiners are those which are weak stem. But when you say lianas, lianas are those which are woody type of climbers. Now the next category possible, what we learned is aerial stems are those stems which are high above, or they are not just at the surface, slightly above or quite above the surface of the soil, and they can be either reduced very much close to the soil, or they can be strong enough to stand tall, or if they are weak, then they need some structures to climb with the help or otherwise coil around. So now the next category possible is subaerial type of stems are those which are weak enough and they don't develop a structure to climb. They don't develop a structure to climb. That means they don't have roots, they don't have tendrils to climb up or thorns to climb up. So they cannot even twine around anticlockwise or clockwise. So they simply spread on the surface. So when they start spreading on the surface, they are called as subepiterranean or called as subaerial type of weak stems. They are even called in simple English as prostrate. Now, prostrate means something growing straight on the surface or horizontal on the surface. And the categories possible are trailers, runners, stolons, and offsets. Now, what are trailers? Let's understand. Trailers are those which simply branch either in one direction or in all directions. So if they branch in all directions, they are called as diffuse. These are trailers have stems and branches which will be spreading. That means they will branch horizontally on the ground. But remember, root system is only found here. So these are only branches merely spreading. These branches will not develop roots anywhere. So the beginning of the plant is from here. So trailers can be diffused. Trailers are called diffuse whenever they have branches going in all directions. They are called as examples I have mentioned with them. Procumbent are those which do not rise up. There are some plants where they will rise up also. Like means here they are spreading in all direction. Here they go in only one direction. Are called as procumbent. There are some example oxalis. There are some plants where they go in one direction and then they rise up. Because they are rising up, they are called as decumbent. It's a weed found everywhere in India, which is called as tridex. Sunflower type of flowers will be there. White color flowers with a yellow center. Very small. They are not big enough. Very small flowers. So trailers are those which will spread either in one direction or spread in all direction. But the rule is that they will have roots only at the main point. They won't produce roots everywhere. They can be diffused. They can be procumbent. They can be decumbent. But runners, now remember, runners, stolons and offsets, they will produce roots wherever they will touch the soil. So this is the difference between trailers and rest of them. Trailers will not produce roots every point where the branch will touch the soil. But in the case of runner, yes, it will develop roots. So if you know grasses, many times you would have uprooted a grass, a long thread type of structure will come. That whole structure was growing basically horizontal, so it's a prostrate one. It was growing horizontal, so it is called as runner. Grasses are the best example of runners, and you must have seen there are nodes on them, and from their branch the roots will grow, and on top you will find leaves will be there. In the same manner, stolons. Now when you talk about strawberry will develop stolons. Stolons are modified runner. Because here the structure is horizontal, here the structure will be arched. This is the only difference between runners and stolons. Next one is offsets. Offsets are runners which are present in only aquatic plants. So same feature will be there.